There are statues all throughout Parliament, but some get more love than others. A number of MPs like to touch their favourite statues for luck. Yes, people in charge of our countries do believe in rubbing statues for luck. The favourite statues seem to be Winston Churchill and Margaret Thatcher's. MPs like touching Churchill's feet so much that they wore down the statues and were ordered to stop. It's said that many MPs have ignored these instructions and continue to give Churchill a cheeky little rub. Parliament was ahead of the rest of the UK in banning smoking way back in the 17th century. When smoking was banned, a snuff box was introduced so the MPs could sniff their tobacco instead. The box is still in the chamber's entrance, full of snuff today. The good news is that MPs are massively into vaping these days, so no one uses it. There are purple ribbons in the members' cloakrooms, which are designed to allow MPs to hang their swords alongside their coats. There are apparently only a few plastic swords hanging from the hooks these days, though the BBC did report that at least one MP still takes advantage of the sword hooks. Every morning the House is in session, a mace is brought into the House. If this mace isn't in place, any debate which takes place is illegal. In fact, to try and stop a debate in 2009, John Macdonald picked up the mace and took it to his seat. It didn't go exactly to plan, as he ended up being suspended from the chamber. All parliamentary debates are typed up and then printed into bound books. This means that the Parliament produces 80 million printed pages every year, which is equivalent to about 1,000 trees. The Green Party said in 2010 they were happy not to have too many MPs in Parliament, as it meant they contributed less to this tree massacre. Okay, I'm sorry, that's a complete lie. Ignore that one. They do still print a lot of books, though. There are strict rules about what MPs can and can't say in the House. They aren't allowed to use any words which might offend the dignity of the House, which means no matter how angry they get, they can't call another MP a f***ing. But there's one unexpected thing which MPs absolutely cannot say in the House. Check out our video which goes into depth about this, the link's in the description. There's a green velvet bag hanging on the back of the Speaker's chair, which is where MPs can place their petitions. I know what you're thinking, why are you telling me about this boring old bag? But it is slightly more than just a tassy bag. This is where the expression of having something in the bag originates from. Still not that interesting, but I think we can all agree I did pull that fact back. In an unusual architectural move, the chamber was built without enough seats for every MP to sit down. MPs have specific areas where they can and can't sit, but most don't have designated seats. If you're interested in finding out who sits where in the House, we have another video about that, which you can find in the description of this video. There are two red lines running down the middle of the chamber. No MP is allowed to step between these two lines during a debate. It's said that they were designed to be just over two sword lengths apart to prevent any sword fighting. At this point, it was beginning to seem like the whole building was designed around medieval weaponry. There's a hairdresser in the House of Commons to help the MPs get a fresh trim without even having to leave the building. And they say that millennials are lazy. Apparently, women's cuts are about £50, which for its central London location seems pretty reasonable. Green is the colour used to represent the House of Commons, as should be pretty obvious by this point. The benches have been coloured green for over 300 years, so if you haven't noticed yet, you're a little behind the programme. Slightly more interestingly though, Westminster Bridge is also painted in a matching green. For more news and politics information, subscribe to TLDR News.